Some consider Thomas Edison one of the greatest inventors ever. Edison was photographed next to a light bulb so often that people came to believe he invented it, but he didn't.
Several inventors had already demonstrated various versions of incandescent lights before Edison patented the first commercially successful light bulb.
Edison never crafted something out of nothing. His genius lay in his ability to craft something better, to perfect what was already available. His critics say his only real invention was taking credit for the inventions of others. So, was he America's greatest inventor, or was Edison a thief? You decide. Edison's life changed when he was 15 years old. One day, when he saw a station official's young son playing by the tracks in the path of an oncoming train, Edison rescued 2-year-old Jimmy McKenzie before a train crushed him. The boy's father was deeply grateful and taught Edison how to operate Morse code on a telegraph machine. This was not easy to do. Operators had to quickly send out signals in dots and dashes, which were converted into letters that made up words and phrases. Edison began working full-time as a telegraph operator in Michigan, where he grew up, and later traveled around America, working at different offices for years. He was able to do this even though he was moderately deaf. He then decided to devote himself to a life as an inventor. Well, actually, he mainly improved upon what was already invented. In 1874, he developed an advanced version of a telegraph machine that could send and receive 4 telegraph messages simultaneously on a single wire, 2 in each direction. His quadruplex telegraph machine enabled his former employer, Western Union, to save money because the company could now send more messages without having to build new lines. Western Union purchased the rights to the invention for $10,000, around $260,000 in value today. Edison used the money to build his great laboratory at Menlo Park, New Jersey. He began by perfecting the telephone there. By 1876, Alexander Graham Bell had found a way to transmit human voices over wires. The telephone was revolutionary. Western Union commissioned Edison to improve upon Bell's invention, to make it practical, and so Edison worked on a telephone transmitter. While working to perfect the phone, he also tried to record the human voice. The phonograph put Edison on the map, giving him the nickname the Wizard of Menlo Park. He began to expand his factory and his appetite for more inventions. His big breakthrough came when he created a successful incandescent light bulb. As I mentioned earlier, others had already been making light bulbs. British inventor Joseph Swan obtained the first patent for a light bulb in Britain 2 years before Edison patented the bulb. Meanwhile, in America, William Sawyer and Albin Mann had received a U.S. patent for the incandescent lamp in 1878.
So what did Edison do? He improved the bulb. Previous versions had only been able to work for a few minutes at a time.
By October 1879, Edison had an aha moment. His bulb with a carbonized filament burned continuously for 14 and a half hours. But that still wasn't good enough for him. He and his assistants tested thousands of plant materials and finally came up with a filament made from bamboo that could last up to 1,200 hours. In 1880, Edison received a historic patent for an improvement to electric lamps. It's been debated whether Edison's patent infringed on Sawyer and Mann's previous patent. Eventually, Edison's American Lighting Company merged with a Thompson-Houston Electric Company, which made incandescent bulbs under the Sawyer-Mann patent. Together, they formed General Electric. On New Year's Eve, 1879, Edison lit up New York's Christie Street, marking the dawn of the electric age. This was at a time when the world still relied on candlesticks.
He then began to mass produce and sell them, but he didn't stop with just improving the light bulb.
Edison then began working on building a system to carry electricity so people could use his light bulbs. In 1882, he set up a large generator plant on Pearl Street in Lower Manhattan and lit the street with electricity. He became rich and famous and ruthless, like when he tried to discredit a rival form of electricity. Edison's generating system used direct current, which has its flaws. DC travels through a power line in one direction at a constant voltage, but can only go up to a mile or so before losing power. So a generating plant was required every few blocks. he hired a young engineer to improve upon his DC generators. But Nikola Tesla came up with a better solution, alternating current. AC periodically changes direction and can also vary its voltage. It can travel hundreds of miles without losing power. Yet when Tesla tried to convince Edison of the advantages of AC, his boss wasn't having any of it. Edison didn't want to lose the royalties he earned from his DC patents. Tesla's AC system caught the attention of American industrialist George Westinghouse, who bought up Tesla's patents. AC generators were spreading fast across the country, faster than Edison's DC system.
So in order to discredit his rival's AC system, Edison devised an ugly strategy.
He gave boys who lived around his New Jersey lab 25 cents for every stray dog they brought him, and organized public electrocutions of these dogs. Edison took every opportunity to question the safety of Tesla's AC system, declaring, "Just as certain as death, Westinghouse will kill a customer within 6 months after he puts in a system of any size." Edison secretly funded the first electric chair, which used AC, despite publicly denouncing capital punishment. The state of New York had commissioned his former assistant, Harold Brown, to build the chair. Brown pushed to have it powered by AC using a Westinghouse generator that he surreptitiously secured through another company. But his schemes didn't work. AC would go on to power the world, much to Edison's dismay.
Yet Edison was more famous than Tesla, and certainly a lot wealthier.
I've done a series of videos on what led to Tesla's tragic demise, which I'll link to in my description. Edison patented a whopping 1,093 inventions in his lifetime. He managed thousands of skilled scientists, machinists, and designers who researched, developed, and manufactured new technologies. So, where did Edison's real genius lie? As Graham Moore writes in his novel, The Last Days of Night, about the feud between Edison and Westinghouse and Tesla, his genius was not in inventing. Rather, it was in inventing a system of invention. Dozens of researchers and engineers and developmental tinkerers labored beneath Edison in a carefully constructed hierarchical organization that he founded and oversaw. In other words, Thomas Edison may not have been a genius inventor or a thief, but a savvy businessman who had a knack for managing people. It was his shrewdness as a manager that allowed him to turn laboratory discoveries into technological marvels in the marketplace, even if many of the original ideas came from someone else. Regardless of how you feel about Edison, his contributions have undoubtedly changed our lives. Whether you're a fan of him or Nikola Tesla, what they both had in common was a firm grasp of math and science. If you'd like to improve your STEM skills, to invent the next great thing, or simply to better understand the world, Brilliant is a website and app where you can learn math, science, and computer science interactively. I know my viewers particularly love their scientific thinking course. In this exercise, you have to make the bridge as rigid as possible with as few beams as possible. Another course popular with my viewers is their pre-algebra course, where you can strengthen your math skills in a fun way where it doesn't feel like learning. If you ever get stuck, you can click the explanation to see where you went wrong. Brilliant is great for those who are in school and also for those who are already working. I personally use Brilliant to help improve my critical thinking skills. You can dedicate a few minutes a day to improving your STEM skills by relearning the basics or having fun with their more advanced courses. And it's free for you to sign up with a custom link in my description, brilliant.org/newsthink. And the first 200 people who sign up with my link will get 20% off Brilliant's annual premium membership, which gives you unlimited access to the hundreds of courses they offer. Thanks for watching. For Newsthink, I'm Cindy Pom.